How much did you kind of enjoy the last win? Does that feel like kind of a get back on track game for you guys?
Yeah, definitely. It definitely felt good just getting it together, playing as a team defensively, offensively, and getting a win in the end is definitely the goal, and I feel like we worked as a team to do that.
Since you've been here, where did that one kind of rank in terms of productivity for yourself in the season, I guess?
What do you mean productivity?
Just like I said, your own impact on the game.
What did it rank compared to just other,
like,
games?
Yeah, I guess. Did that feel like maybe the most complete one you've had here?
Complete just because we won. Yeah, absolutely.
You guys have obviously faced, you know, the knock on this team has been dealing with length and physicality coming into this game. How is that going to play a role here with the Pelicans?
It's definitely going to play a role, but we got to get over everything that's our deficiencies, I guess, and figure out a way to get a win. That's we're professionals, so we gotta go out there and do what we have to do.
How much are you looking forward to this knockout round?
I'm very excited. This is amazing. I've had a lot of fun in these games. Just the energy behind it, the way the fans are coming in, and I like the jersey colors, the courts. It's pretty cool.
Did game prep feel like a playoff game at all?
It does sort of have that feel, because money online, and so I feel like for some guys, you know, it doesn't matter if it's the $50,000 or $100,000, it's still a lot of money. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. For my years in the league, this is the most anticipation we've had for an in-season game.
I know Mike's detailed anyways with his pregame scouts, but was this like even denser, like even more about?
It was, but it wasn't because it was that. It was more of, this is an opportunity for us to win the series against them. If we win this game, then I think we play them two more times, so we can go 3-2 in the series just in case we see them in the playoffs or something. So that's what he was more focused on rather than the in-season tournament aspect of it.
What didn't go right for you guys defensively against Zion when you were in?
We just let him get to the rim way too many times. We didn't make him shoot any shots outside the paint. We didn't load a lot and really make him see a lot of bodies. So we definitely have to do that.
In a league full of unique challenges, just what kind of unique challenges is it to defend Zion Williamson?
It's definitely unique challenges to guard such an aggressive and strong body coming to the paint and athletic at that same point. You really don't see a lot of guys his strength and weight with the same athleticism. So it's definitely a unique guard. But I feel like we have the tools to do it. So we'll see tonight.
Prior to coming to Sacramento, I mean, you probably had one vision of what De'Aaron Fox is. Is this kind of his productivity so far to start this season? Is it kind of eclipsed maybe even that impression you might have had?
I've always known he was a great player, and his pace is crazy and his speed is crazy. But I didn't really have the vision of how well of a scorer he is. So yeah, it definitely opened my eyes.
JaVale, coach gave you just a ton of credit after last game about how you stepped in and really for a lot of these young guys. How much have you been enjoying that?
I enjoy it for sure. I definitely enjoy it. I've been in this league a long time. I've got a lot of knowledge of a lot of things happening, bad and good. And I'd definitely be a sounding board for things that can go wrong and things that can go right. So I appreciate it.
Some might call it corny, but what's it like to have the defensive player of the game crown?
That motherfucking crown, heavy as hell. God damn, I thought I was about to get a concussion or something. But it was cool. It was real cool. I mean, you got to go out there and perform on the court to even get it. So it felt good.
You've been in this league a long time. Something as small as that can be kind of a rallying cry for a lot of teams, right?
It definitely makes a difference. Even if your stats aren't showing up on the stat sheet, just getting that defensive player and knowing that your deflections mattered and you the way you dove in those 50-50 balls mattered, it just breeds a whole different type of player to where, yeah, I'm not going out there and scoring 30, but I'm that player who just works hard and does every little thing that I have to do for the team. So it's definitely a cool thing.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks, Bill. Appreciate it.